Not completely alerted yet. We'll continue on our journey here. Hopefully we won't be stranded for fuel. Maybe we'll find something in this system. Dish. Check out the atmosphere. Asteroid belt. Cleanse island. Alright. Jar Tar. Not Jar Jar, please. Jar Tar is a terrestrial world with a trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. Its surface is hot and primarily composed of unremarkable silicates. Occasional deposits of aluminum, magnesium, and other light metals can be found. Jar Tar is noted for the discovery of the Leviathan of Dis, right, the apparent corpse of a genetically engineered living starship. The Leviathan was found in the bottom of a crater by a Batarian survey team and estimated to be nearly a billion years old. It disappeared after a visit to the system by a Batarian dreadnought 20 years ago. Since then, the Batarians have steadfastly denied that the Leviathan existed at all, all the more vociferously when shown recordings of the corpse made by Solarian researchers. Interesting. Yeah, we were searching this system from the doctor, what's his name's quarters? Lab, rather. Nerum. Nerum is a terrestrial world with a thin atmosphere of methane and argon. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of basaltic rock. Its most prominent feature is the Ellos Rift Valley, a long volcanic divergence zone that stretches across half of the northern hemisphere. Third planet this way. Clensal. Clensal has a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and ethane. Its first geological surveys were performed by Batarians and suggested areas of great mineral wealth. Human mining concerns spent billions of credits hustling to the distant system and sinking test bores to claim the system for humanity. But Clensal had only an average level of mineral wealth, valuable but hardly worth the rush and expense. Merida Industria, a small Mexican company hoping to strike it rich in their first extrasolar mining venture, had to file for bankruptcy protection. Hey, that's racist. Investigation revealed the Batarian crew had deliberately falsified their surveys, hoping it would encourage human rivals to invest in a costly boondoggle. That's a new word to me. I never heard that. Boondoggle? While unethical, this was not technically illegal, and the Batarian government disavowed the personal actions of a few misguided patriots. The planet is still littered with abandoned mining bases, which are often used as temporary meeting places for criminals. Great. What a great legacy. Well, that's the... I thought I came upon something. This way is... Gremar. Gremar is an icy terrestrial with a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and krypton. Its surface is mainly composed of frozen ammonia with deposits of tin and other light metals. When exposed to sunlight, Gremar's ammonia can melt, forming equatorial seas of the toxic chemical. This has allowed a profusion of simple fungus and lichens to evolve in the low-energy environment. A byproduct of their metabolism causes them to glow very faintly. While the light of an individual is insignificant, large patches seem to reinforce the light of one another and are visible from space. But I can't see them. Oh, got a gas giant this way. Raisha. Raisha is a standard hydrogen-helium gas giant with traces of sodium and ammonia in its atmosphere. During the brief gold rush to Clensal, a few companies established an infrastructural for helium-3 skimming and deuterium mining on Raisha's icy moons. When Clensal proved to be less wealthy than expected, the facilities were stripped for parts and abandoned. Okay, those are all the planets. Shall I listen for the sound? I know I went around the asteroid belt. Check the inside here. Not hearing anything except us bumping into planets. Wait. You know, it would be in the exact last place I scanned. Oh my god, they're really alert. 200 units of fuel. This time I'll let it add up so we can see. 50%. Oh my god. Okay, we have to escape from this area, or to this area. Altogether possible we might not, find everything. Let's check the first two planets in the system. And we might have to come back here later on. Actually. Hold up. Oh god, I have to go. It's by Clensal.
Evasion successful.
Can I come back? So I got... Alright. If I die, we will just restore 61. You know, if they really wanted to make it hard, they could make it so you can't... You can only save in a system. I'm probably gonna die. They go faster than my ship, so the Normandy, obviously. Probe away. Credits. We got credits. Never mind. Where am I? Oh.
Reapers eluded.
I'm trying. No, we're gonna die. They're too close to us. I'm gonna try to head just straight north. Or whatever you'd call it. That's annoying as hell. I feel like we almost made it though. It's annoying scanning for it every time we're not knowing we're gonna make it. This is my last try, guys. My god!
Reapers eluded.
Nice. Okay, cool. Heading to Farinata. I hope we find some fuel here in Farinata. Three planets. Let's check out the asteroid belt. Ah!
I found something.
Oh my god, they're so alert. 200 units. Yikes! We got one more asset. These planets are so far apart, we can't scan them all. Tunshagan. I'll start here, right? With my scanning. Tunshagan is a hydrogen helium gas giant with traces of chlorine and nitrogen in its atmosphere. It has an unusually small number of moons for a gas giant, a mere 7. This is likely due to the star Farinata capturing the majority of the mass during the nebular collapse that created the system. Second planet is up here. Juntoma. Juntoma is a small, broiling terrestrial world. Its thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and ethane is being steadily blown off by the powerful solar wind from the star Farinata. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of sulfur with deposits of copper. Its density is low enough to leave the world tidally locked to Farinata. The Alliance Defense Data Network notes that several ships have been spotted cruising near Juntoma with transponders turned off. While an Alliance patrol attempted pursuit of one, the unidentified vessel rabbited to FTL. Its trail was lost when it obscured its light trace in the confusion of signals along the Anansi-Ishtar shipping lane. And stuff. And finally... Did I check out both? I think I stopped, didn't I? Nepnu. Talking about the asteroid belts, guys. With a rare combination of features, Nepnu is of particular interest to the scientific community. Nepnu is a small terrestrial planet with a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and krypton. As with the worlds of Farinata, its surface is scorching hot. The crust mainly consists of silicates laced with iron. Alright, let's check out both. Asteroid belts. Since I forgot which one, I'm pretty sure I was looking at the outer one. Okay, well, the Reapers are gonna come from that direction. There's one coming from that direction. In that direction. So we're gonna head that way. We can't scan both planets, unfortunately. So we're gonna scan this one. We could probably also scan that one, but there'll probably be nothing there. It's a gas giant. My god, we got to run. I didn't save, though. I think we auto-save when we enter the system, though. What? Yeah, I'm following the white indicator, okay? My mouse pad is only so big, thank you. Probe away. Alliance frigate Agincourt. For the Alliance First Fleet. Now hopefully we can get away. Oh my god. 100%. Nice. Yikes!
Faster than light, not successful.
I hope you find more fuel. Caicus. We might make it there. We kind of zoomed into this location, so it's closer. I think it's closer than it might actually be. Last system, though. Caicus. Alright. Let's check out Zayartar. An enigmatic terrestrial planet, Zayartar has a hazy atmosphere of nitrogen and argon. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of calcium with deposits of sodium. Three times in the last century, ships stopping to discharge at Treyarmus have reported geometric patterns of lights on the dark side of Zayartar. I think we should scan this planet. Attempts at closer investigation prove fruitless. The lights disappear when ships... when ships move approach the inner system. What? Yes, and the grammar is kind of, mysterious as well. Chohei. I remember the Caicos system and the Chohei planet. Chohei is a terrestrial planet whose surface is mainly composed of aluminum, with numerous deposits of calcium. Though it has enough mass to retain a dense atmosphere, Chohei is nearly a vacuum. This lack of atmosphere allows a moderate average temperature, but the difference between night and day are extreme. The surface of Chohei's sunward-facing side is usually covered by a haze of volatiles. Mainly water vapor and carbon dioxide. Hold on a second. Yes, excuse me, although I technically didn't do anything. Which returned to the ground as frost over the course of the long, cold night. The Serta Foundation has established a research outpost on Chohei to investigate the native subterranean life of Chohei, which shows incredible resilience to extremes of heat and cold. Cool. Adapting to their environment. Third rock from the sun is this tiny thing. Zamari. Zamari is a small, airless, cratered terrestrial, a lifeless rock quite similar to Luna. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of silicates, though one hemisphere has several seas of dark basaltic rock. I'm gonna check out the, asteroid belt. Why can't I fly straight? What the hell? Okay. I kind of strayed over here. Let me just check that out. Then we'll look at this planet. Two gas giants. Okay. There's a lot to this cluster. Farangor. So we have Farinata and Farangor. A large but low-density terrestrial world, Farangor is generally believed to consist mainly of water ice. Occasional upwelling of metals caused by the interacting tidal forces of several large moons suggests the core is small but extremely dense. Farangor has a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and ethane. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of dark carbon-laced water ice. 13 years ago, Farangor's grim surface color and dim illumination drew the cinematographer Risa Uvarsson to film the exterior scenes of Starless on location. Acknowledged as a masterpiece of gothic horror, the sets, well preserved by the vacuum, draw hundreds of tourists to the backwater system every year. So this is like the Amityville horror of planets then. Interesting. Atmospheric pressure 0. Freaking cold, man. I like to see the movie Starless. Treormis. Treormis is a hydrogen-helium gas giant with a powerful magnetic field, making it a popular discharge site for freighters working the Anansi-Ishtar shipping route. It is popular enough, in fact, that Quarian ships can often be found loitering in orbit, selling the freighter crews cheap refreshments, salvage, and odd craftworks assembled by their children. There are no ships in orbit at present, however. Okay. Alright, now we have to see if we can find something. That's our last system, guys, for this cluster. We'll be heading on after this. Oh, I left by mistake. Crap, I'm over here. Although I wonder if these things go in an orbit. it might change the location every time you enter the system. Of course, the ones on planets will be the same. Just don't leave the system. I am not hearing anything.
Signal confirmed.
Yikes. Chohei. The mouse keeps going off the mouse pad. Probe launched. Credits recovered. I was hoping for some gas. We won't find that on a planet, though. Yeah, they're really alert to us right now. 50%. Try scanning this way. If we find fuel, we'll definitely be able to get back. There might be something on another planet. Don't leave the system. Oh, I hear it. Unfortunately, there's a Reaper coming right there. I don't want to leave in case it moves. Fuel, 400 units. Haha. I think they would have come. They would have came. I don't want to test it. Anyway, we're completely done. Yay, so proud. Done with Hades Gamma. This little section of these two here. Crescent Nebula is one of the other ones. Maybe there'll be some fuel here? If not, I might have to go back. There's no Reaper here, so it shouldn't be a problem. Cool. There's no Reaper presence in here. Not fair. 350 units. Hey, we're almost full. Cool. 50%. So we need some more stuff. Let's check out these planets. I'll probably sit right here and scan them both. So this is the Tessala system in the Crescent Nebula. Barragal. While not a classical hothouse world like Venus, Barragal is scarcely more hospitable. In addition to being closest to the star Tessal, its core contains many of radioactives and other heavy elements. These increase the heat of the planets and drive volcanism. I need a drink here. And to fix my hair. Barragal's crust is too rigid for plate tectonics to function, and the planet will go through cycles in which the pressure builds to a massive supervolcanic eruption. These spew ejecta over thousands of kilometers, leave caldera 100 kilometers across, and spew enough molten material to repave entire continents. The last such event was 812,000 years ago. The current rate of outgassing from volcanic hotspots suggests another will occur within the next 10 millennia. Ilium! Oh wow, Ilium. Ilium is a classic garden world, and Antrapot... That's a new... What is all those flickerings? See how it's flickering like that? Anyway, whatever this is, Antrapot between the Terminus systems and the Asari Republics. To abet this trade, the normally stringent customs laws of Council Space on product safety, prescribed materials, and sapient trafficking are relaxed. The world is hot and massive. Ground settlement is only possible at the higher polar latitudes. In more equatorial locations, the population is housed in arcology skyscrapers to escape the heat of the surface. Reaper forces met a surprising amount of resistance at Ilium. Its leaders were paranoid about keeping their fortunes and were influential in both Terminus and Citadel space. They acquired a large defense fleet and a high number of fission weapons, and in the brief space battle used them on the Reaper fleet's troop transports rather than the near-impervious capital ships. As a result, the inevitable ground invasion has been slowed to a crawl as the Reapers manufacture more troops. Colony was founded in 1617. Population on the surface is 84,950,000, and on the L4 and L5 stations, 80,500. Pre-invasion estimates. Capital is Nos Astra. I wonder if any scan will produce results there. Panolis. A fairly typical Venusian hothouse, Panolis seems almost tame compared to the violent volcanic outbursts of the inner world Barragal. In contrast, Panolis is nearly inert, with no active volcanoes or plate tectonics. The most dramatic event in the last million years was the foundering of the Asari Aerostat research platform Alveusic in 2092, which fell after being holed by an improbably unlucky meteor. Alright, I think they were unlucky, not the meteor. Most of the crew successfully reached escape capsules, but six were lost. The crushed wreck of the platform now lies on the Creosite Plain in the Southern Hemisphere. There's a wreck there, I wonder if that would be helpful. Oh, I barely saw that. Oh, I need to travel around the, what do you call it? Asteroid belt. Tukria, named for a legendary Asari archer from Theseus' Iron Age, Tukria is an asteroid large enough to qualify as a dwarf planet, or, as some term it, a mesoplanet. Its gravity is sufficient to give it a spherical shape. Developed for nickel and iron mining, Tukria was abandoned before the Reapers reached the system. Its facilities are now dark and cold. Let's check out the rest of the belt here. Because I came across that purely by accident. And that's it. Okay. Gas giant. Thale. Thale is a typical hydrogen-helium gas giant. Its complex system of rings is unstable, dating back only a few million years. They are thought to be the shattered remains of a comet. A lot of comets and meteors falling around here. Up there, I see. Keep going. Nexel. Nexel is an ammonia methane ice giant, or ice giant, not gas giant. Several smaller energy corporations shut out of the big market in the Fea Gateway system are attempting to develop a local helium-3 fuel mining infrastructure to service Ilium. The leading investor is the human corporation Eldfell Ashland Energy. Sorry guys, I don't know what's going on with me now. Their efforts have been hampered by the extra legal pressure the H3 cartels in Fea system can bring to bear, from simple price undercuts to bureaucratic obstructions, denied permits, and constant health and safety inspections. Population is 6,700. Capital is EAE Krafla. I guess on the moons, there's no mention of gravity, and who could live on there? Okay, so Reapers will come from there. A Reaper will come from here, and Lucarne. They're not that alert, but I'm sure the next one is gonna bring them almost to full alertness. We'll see if we can find the last one. Right in the middle here. Good. Yeesh. On Ilium. Probe away. Liquid assets. Huh. I wonder what that is. Well, we're done. And we can safely come back here. They really did well against the Reapers here? Wow. Alright, so... Lucarne and back. That's not far.